It's Jacqueline.
My mom's back for another YouTube video. Peace.
So, hi. Yes, I am back with another video. So some of this is going to be a little bit of a recap of my old video about Tollovid, but I also want to talk about my experience with Paxlovid. So first, as you guys know, my husband tested positive in April, and shortly thereafter, I did develop some symptoms. I got the monoclonals, but I was still having some symptoms. So as we went over in my last video, my four main symptoms at that time were chest tightness, GI pain, burning in my hands and feet, and headaches. So after a few weeks had passed, I learned about a supplement called Tollovid, and I ordered it online, and within 2 to 3 days, the burning of hands and feet and the headaches went completely away. So I do believe that there was a complete resolution of symptoms, of those two symptoms from the Tollovid. The GI pain and the chest tightness did seem to linger for a few more weeks, but by the end of May, beginning of June, I was feeling pretty good. I felt like pretty much all of the symptoms had resolved. So I just want to rewind back for a moment, because in April, when my husband tested positive, I did call my doctor and I did ask him, if I test positive, would I be able to get Paxlovid? So his response was, I certainly can prescribe Paxlovid to you. I don't know if you're going to find a pharmacy to fill it for you. He said he had had two other patients that had asked for Paxlovid. He wrote them prescriptions and they were not able to find any local pharmacies to fill the prescription. This is Burbank, California. This is not some remote area, and he couldn't find any pharmacies to fill the prescription. So this was in April. So obviously I didn't have any Paxlovid at that time. I got monoclonals and then I ended up taking the Tollovid. So that brings me to mid-June, when, as you guys know, my son went to summer camp. He tested positive for COVID. I end up developing symptoms. I end up getting a sore throat and I'm feeling really tired. So at this time, I do end up asking my doctor if I am able to get Paxlovid. This is a different doctor. This is a long COVID doctor, and he is able to get me Paxlovid from a local, kind of like a local mom-pa pharmacy. So I want to also just talk about right there about the accessibility of getting Paxlovid. So first of all, the first time I try to get Paxlovid or just inquire about Paxlovid, I'm told that we may not have a pharmacy that can fill it for you. Then I also want to throw in this story, because I have a relative, 75-year-old male. He tests positive on a home test. His wife tests positive for COVID on a home test as well. She is able to get Paxlovid. She does get a PCR also, PCR positive. She takes Paxlovid. This family member calls in and asks if he can have a prescription for Paxlovid. He tested positive on a home test, and they tell him that he has to have a positive PCR test in order for the pharmacy to fill the prescription. He lives in a small town. He has to go to the urgent care. So at this point now, he has to expose other people to COVID. They obviously know he has COVID, but it's still, you're going out there, you are exposing other people. He has to get this PCR test. Then he has to wait about 2 days to get the PCR results back. He gets them back, they are positive. And then the pharmacy tells him they cannot fill the prescription because too much time has now elapsed between symptoms and this positive test, and that Paxlovid would not be recommended anymore. This pharmacy says 2 to 3 days, which if you actually look it up, it is 5 days from onset of symptoms, but they will not fill his prescription. So first of all, that's one thing when we're looking at is accessibility to even getting Paxlovid. Number two are the side effects of Paxlovid. So I did start taking Paxlovid, like I mentioned, for this June infection. And the main side effect I had was an awful taste in my mouth. And it's something that I can't even describe. Some people have described it as metallic. It did not taste metallic. It just was awful. And honestly, I couldn't even concentrate or think about anything else for those 5 days besides that awful taste in my mouth. Now, I know that other people have had other side effects. I didn't have anything that I was aware of as far as side effects from Paxlovid. Next is the Paxlovid rebound. So I do believe that I did experience a rebound. So I had a sore throat and fatigue for the first few days. I did wait several days before I even started Paxlovid to avoid this rebound. My symptoms started on a Thursday. I took Paxlovid on Monday. On Monday night was my first dose. So the last dose was on the following Saturday. I, in general, like, didn't feel great during that time. I had a sore throat. I felt tired. But it wasn't until the Tuesday after I had stopped Paxlovid that I just got hit really, really hard with symptoms. I was so tired. I had to lay in bed for 3 days. My sore throat was awful. It felt like strep. So I definitely feel like I was one of the people that suffered that Paxlovid rebound, even though I waited, 4 days or so to even start the prescription. I do know that there is an ER doc back in Burbank that recommended breaking up those last few doses over the course of several days to prevent this rebound from happening. But again, no one really knows what exactly they're supposed to do. If you guys have been following the news, you will know that Dr. Fauci also suffered a Paxlovid rebound. He had 4 doses of the vaccine, and he also suffered a rebound with Paxlovid, and he was given a second prescription of Paxlovid. Obviously, with just accessibility to getting one course of Paxlovid, I can only imagine how difficult it would be to get 2 courses of Paxlovid if you do rebound. I don't even know if that would be recommended. Of course, we don't have a lot of data for all of this. So in some ways, it is just unfortunately a guessing game. Also, there are contraindications with Paxlovid and other medications. Some patients are told not even to start Paxlovid because it can interfere with some of their other medications. So if this is something for you, you could possibly take Tollovid instead of Paxlovid. And there are people that just don't want to take Paxlovid at all. So Tollovid could potentially be another alternative for you. I do believe it can help with acute infection and possibly long COVID as well. Also, the length of time that you can take Tollovid is much longer. I was on it for 30, 35 days without having any side effects or anything that I was aware of. And I felt that it was beneficial for me. Obviously, Paxlovid is a 5-day course and you don't really have access to taking it longer than that. And I don't even know that anyone would want to take it longer than that, but there is obviously that limitation with Paxlovid. So I just wanted to do a little roundup here of the differences with Tollovid and my experience with Paxlovid. And again, if any of you have had any experience with either, please leave a comment below. I will be in touch to give you guys further updates on my experience, but I did just want to give you guys the information of my experience with Paxlovid. Until then, guys, be well, stay safe. Peace.
I'm glad you made it here.
Cause we're here. Make sure to like and subscribe.